Hey everyone, it is Josh here from HostGator. Today we're going to go through the process of registering a brand new domain. So let's get started. Now you've probably taken some time to think of the perfect domain for your business, your blog, your website. And now it's time to see if it's available online and see if you can register it. So we're going to start out here in the customer portal, and I'll also show you how to do this if you're not currently a customer as well. So if you're logged into your customer portal, we're going to click on the domains tab here on the left-hand side. And that's going to take us to our domain management section, where I can manage every domain that I have already, or I can register a new one or transfer an existing one from a different registrant if I want to. So I'm going to click on the register a domain button there at the top, and it's going to take me to the search domain section. Now that's how you get there if you're from the customer portal, but you can also go to hostgator.com/domains and start this process right away. It's pretty much the same from here on out. Just wanted to show you two different ways to get there. So let's head back, and what I'm going to do is type in the name of the domain that I want to try and register today. I want to get joshmakestutorials.com. So what I'm going to do is type that name into the search bar and then click search. Give it a few seconds to think and check across the web to see if anybody has it, and they don't. I can absolutely register this domain. Very cool. So now that I know it's available, the next thing I want to do is look here at the add domain privacy. Now, what this is really important depending on what you want for your business. So I'm going to go back to our customer portal here and show you what I mean. So domain privacy essentially allows us to mask all of the information that's available on the web for my domain. So whenever you register a domain, your email, your address, and your name is going to be visible if you don't have privacy protection. So it's important to come here into the customer portal to see what that current information is set to. Now, if you don't want your email address, your address, or your phone number out publicly visible on the web, it's a good idea to add that domain privacy protection. Now, I also want to think about one special thing here, and that's my primary email that's on file. So in order to register a domain, I'm going to have to get an email sent to me to verify that, you know, I'm actually a person. So I always want to make sure that my primary email is up to date and that I can actually get email there. Because if I can't click the verification from that email, then it's going to take a long time to register this domain. So now that I've checked that all my information is correct, I'm going to head back and I'm going to complete the process. So I'm going to leave privacy protection on. I think it's a great cost, $15 a year, pretty good, so that way I don't get a whole bunch of spam emails and calls. And now that I know that my domain is there, I'm going to do one more thing. I'm going to double check to make sure that my domain name is spelled correctly. I have registered an incorrectly spelled domain before. It was cool. I bit the cost. I just made a testing website for about a year. But always double and triple check that just to make sure it's exactly what you want to register. Now, the next thing that you're going to choose is your payment option. If you've got a card on file, cool, go ahead and use that. You can add a new card here. For me, I'm going to use the PayPal option, and then we'll click continue to check out. Now, it's going to do a double verification here for me, and it's going to give me the name of the domain, the fact that I have privacy protection, and it'll actually give me the option to register it for longer if I want to. For me, I just want this for a year, so I think it'll be good for me. Now on here, you have the option to set custom name servers. So if you've already watched our earlier videos on how to track down your name servers for your domain, you can put those here and save a little time, or you can leave them and it'll put the default name servers. You can also enhance your online presence if you buy a couple of extra TLDs. So if you want joshmakestutorials.site, .info, .org, you can always pick those as well. And if you've got a discount coupon code, you can go ahead and add that. So we'll scroll down to the bottom, and you've got our terms of service, the domain registry policy, and the privacy policy, which you're always welcome to read. Once you've accepted all of those, click that little checkbox and click place your order. And after that, it's really just the process of the payment being made, and all you'll really need to do is wait for the domain to provision. And so it can take some time, usually 24 to 48 hours for the provisioning process. Once it's done, you'll actually see that domain inside of your portal. So we can head back and I'll show you what that looks like. Click on domains here. And as you can see here, I've got Josh Makes Tutorials and it says domain pending, payment has not yet been received. Once I complete that payment on PayPal, it's going to go into the provisioning process, usually 24 to 48 hours. And that's it. You just registered a brand new domain. Congrats. Thanks again for watching, y'all. I hope you have a great day, and leave some comments or some suggestions below for new videos, and subscribe if you want to see more. Thanks, y'all.